What's up, nature lovers? I'm Heather from Highland Nature. Did you see the news reported by the Tribune about the nearly extinct Western monarch butterfly? The Pismo Beach butterfly grove has seen a 3,500% increase in its monarch population compared to the numbers last year. Seeing as how we went last year and saw only 200, we had to go up and see it for ourselves. Check it out. Did you know the Western Monarch is a different species than the Eastern one that is commonly known for migrating from Mexico to Canada and back again? The Western Monarch is found on the west coast of the United States and has a shorter migration, usually totaling around 600 miles from their overwintering sites in California. Historically, Pismo Beach has been one of several locations the Monarchs choose to overwinter. Take a look at how the numbers have changed over the years just at Pismo Beach. You see that in 1990, the monarch count was 230,000. 10 years later, we see a huge drop to 40,000. 20 years later, after that, in 2020, there were only 200 at this location. And in all of California, there were only estimated to be 2,000 Western monarchs left. Scientists had expected this would be the definitive collapse of the species, but for some reason, this year, a monarch miracle is happening. As of the first weekend in November 2021, roughly 14,000 monarchs have been counted at the Pismo Beach overwintering grove. From the end of September until the end of February, these monarchs will mostly roost high in the trees until they mate in February and restart the next generation. It takes 4 generations of butterflies to leave here in February, then make their way back here in the fall. Generations 1 to 3 typically live 2 to 5 weeks. But the 4th generation, the ones up in these trees, can live from 6 to 9 months. That's why it is so important that this uptick in population is happening. This generation is responsible for the survival of the species and starting the entire process over again in the spring. Monarchs choose locations like these for overwintering because of the unique microclimates that characterize them and are not known for freezing temperatures. Additionally, access to fresh water, winter blooming flowers, and large trees that protect them from strong winds are needed. So this is great news for the Western Monarch, but if we are going to celebrate this uptick in numbers, we need to understand what some of the contributing factors were that led to their decline so we can avoid making the same mistakes in the future. Most people are aware of the big reasons that monarchs, like most species seeing a decline in population, are taking a hit. Habitat loss created for farming and more room for humans to live and work continue to be a threat. Climate change and wildfires are also responsible for so many species seeing a decline in their population. Let's pause right here. For many of us, when we hear about these reasons for species in decline, we check out and we think there isn't anything we can do to help. And I'm not here to discourage you from doing anything you can to stop climate change or to reduce your carbon footprint. But there is an area for most of us that love monarch butterflies where we can have a direct impact on the overall health of the species. Most consumers, myself included, have known that monarch populations have been in decline for quite a while. So we rush out and we buy some milkweed at our local store. And the milkweed that is typically found in big box stores is a tropical milkweed that is not native. There's a parasite that thrives on tropical milkweed. As a monarch caterpillar eats its way to adulthood, they'll consume the milkweed leaves and at the same time consume the parasite on the leaves. You'll think you have so many healthy looking caterpillars, and then when it comes time for them to pupate, death. The OE parasite now inside the caterpillar attacks the caterpillar from inside and most often will either die during pupation or simply never emerge from their chrysalis. Take a deep breath. This is where you can help. You don't need to kill or uproot your tropical milkweed. At this point, the Western monarch population still depends on having enough food to raise more monarchs to increase their population. So if you have tropical milkweed like me, cut it down to the base from the end of October through December. Make this an annual tradition. When your tropical milkweed grows back, and yes, give it a few weeks, it should grow back and look great in the spring. All the new leaves will be free of the parasite. Unfortunately, these migratory creatures pick up the parasite at one tropical milkweed plant and then spread it to another as they go through their life. By cutting down your tropical milkweed from late October to December, you help ensure this parasite does not exist in such a high density. Reducing the density of the OE parasite means more caterpillars can successfully pupate, emerge from their chrysalis, and continue building a healthy population of monarchs. Another thing you can do to help monarchs, if you're in the position to do so, consider planting native species of milkweed. The OE parasite does not live on native milkweed species. Native milkweed species vary by region. I'll leave a link below for a species reference by region. We're all excited about the increased population of Western monarchs, so please help us keep this momentum going. I hope you enjoyed the video, and please consider hitting the subscribe button. Take care.